করো এই দাসে তৃণ পে খাতিহীনা সকল সহনে বলা দিয়া করো সকল সহনে বলা দিয়া করো সকল মানে স্পৃহহীনা নিজ মানে স্পৃহহীনা গুরুদেব কৃপা বিন্দু দিয়া করো এই দাসে তৃণ পে খাতিহীনা করো এই দাসে তৃণ পে খাতিহীনা সকলে সম্মান করিতে সকতি দেহ নাথ যত যত সকলে সম্মান করিতে সকতি দেহ নাথ যত যত তবে তো গাইব হরি নাম সুখে তবে তো গাইব হরি নাম সুখে তবে তো অপরাধ বেহাত গুরুদেব কৃপা বিন্দু দিয়া করো এই দাসে তৃণ পে খাতিহীনা করো এই দাসে তৃণ পে খাতিহীনা কবে হেন কৃপা লভিয়ায়ে জানা কৃতার্থ হইবে নাতা কবে হেন কৃপা লভিয়ায়ে জানা কৃতার্থ হইবে নাতা শক্তি বুদ্ধিহীনা আমি অতি দীনা শক্তি বুদ্ধিহীনা আমি অতি দীনা শক্তি বুদ্ধিহীনা আমি অতি দীনা শক্তি সাতা করো মোরে আত্মা সাতা গুরুদেব কৃপা বিন্দু দিয়া করো এই দাসে তৃণ পে খাতিহীনা করো এই দাসে তৃণ পে খাতিহীনা। अज्ञाता विचारे किछु नाही पाए तोमार करुणा सारा। अज्ञाता विचारे किछु नाही पाए तोमार करुणा सारा। करुणा ना होइले कांदिया कांदिया, 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 प्राण ना रखिबो त्रिन पे खाती ही ना। गुरुदेव कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ऐ दासे त्रिन पे खाती ही ना। गुरुदेव कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ऐ दासे त्रिन पे खाती ही ना। कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ऐ दासे त्रिन पे खाती ही ना।
ज्ञान तिमरंधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुर्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंदेहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सकना रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सकना ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितंश्च। हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांता राधाकांता नमोस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। वंशकल्पतरूभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा गुरु महाराज, प्लीज एक्सेप्ट आवर रेस्पेक्टफुल एंड हम्बल ओबेसेंसेस ऑन दिस ऑस्पिशियस डे एट योर होली फीट। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू यू एंड ऑल ग्लोरीज टू श्रील प्रभुपाद। ऑन दिस ऑस्पिशियस ओकेशन ऑफ योर डिवाइन 75th अपीयरेंस डे, we feel very humbled and honored to express our heartfelt gratitude towards you. We are so indebted to you for accepting us and giving us Diksha, which is giving us Divya Jnana and taking away our karmas. Our heartfelt gratitude for becoming our inspiration and our divine link to the parampara that we can latch on to. In the Nectar of Devotion, Srila Prabhupada states that the qualification of a spiritual master is that he must have realized the conclusion of the scriptures by deliberation and arguments, and thus be able to convince others of these conclusions. Such great personalities who have taken shelter of the Supreme Godhead, leaving aside all material considerations, are to be understood as bona fide spiritual masters. And everyone should try to find such a bona fide spiritual master in order to fulfill the mission of life, which is to transfer himself or herself to the plane of spiritual bliss. And when we look at your association, you are every bit of that and more, and we thank you for your kind association. Our association with you started with us attending the weekend classes with our kids about 5 years ago. At that time, we were new to Krishna consciousness, even though we knew a little bit of it theoretically through other associations and classes. After consistently hearing from you, every weekend, our transformation has begun. Your association brought us clarity in terms of what is the purpose of life. It really enhanced our relationships within the family. It nurtured our children. In fact, we feel like they've really grown under your shelter and really matured and blossomed into real children. We feel satisfied and content in our hearts and feel protected under your shelter. Looking back at what we were a few years back and what we are now shows how taking up this Krishna consciousness, which is a perfect science, under the guidance and mercy of a bona fide spiritual master like your eternal self, can bring a day and night difference in the life of people, humble people like us. This year, I have personally seen seismic shift in our life. I lost my father, but at the same time, you have extended to be our eternal spiritual father and taken us under your shelter to guide us to the Supreme Father. Thank you. Guru Maharaj, throughout the entire journey, even of my father leaving the body, you have guided us and taught us the duties of a child, duties of a son, so that we can really deliver the generations before us and after us by becoming a sincere and pure devotee of the Lord. Thank you for your wonderful guidance. We have been closely observing your perfected Krishna conscious life and are completely awestruck. Just following your instructions and trying to be even an iota of your sincerity towards your Guru Maharaj will bring us to perfection. Your countless years of perseverance, sacrifice have helped build this temple, this organization, and created an ambience that has been nurturing many, many Vaishnavas who are now really empowered to take this mission even forward and spread it even greatly. Your commitment to your Guru Maharaj is beyond anyone's imagination. Just like Srila Prabhupada used to always meditate on how to fulfill his Guru's instructions, your constant meditation on Srila Prabhupada's instructions completely, engulf us in terms of those deep thoughts towards you. We hear you always repeating only Srila Prabhupada's words and in fact emphasize and ensure not to add any speculative theories beyond it. I have never seen you say anything without referring to a verse or a purport of Prabhupada. That is unbelievable, amazing, and there are no words to describe. That shows how much time you have spent in really understanding every word of Srila Prabhupada to make sure that we are given that perfect message. In fact, we may not have the direct association of Srila Prabhupada, but you have your association and your classes have given us an opportunity to really feel every iota of every message that Srila Prabhupada intended to deliver to his disciples and generations after. You are so compassionate to take this perfect science of devotional service towards the Lord Krishna in spite of all odds and challenges, and really has single-handedly delivered and driven this Vedic cultural center and its reach to greater Seattle area. Whether it is taking to a food truck or farm, Ahimsa milk, initially, for me, it was hard to understand how all these were connected. But under your regular association, we're able to see that you have perfected the real understanding of Krishna consciousness, and you know how to apply that to every walk of life. And thank you for your great association. And we are really humbled to be your disciples. And we prostrate ourselves at your lotus feet for all that you have done and been doing for Lord Chaitanya's and Srila Prabhupada's mission of spreading Krishna consciousness. And we sincerely pray to Sri Sri Radha Nila Madhav, Jagannath Baladev Subhadra, Sri Taram Lakshman, Gaur Nitha, and Srila Prabhupada to bestow good health and long life to continue your mission to spread this great science, the culture of devotional service to thousands and thousands and millions in, along Washington and across the world. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Vilas, Hare Krishna, Hare Vilas Maharaj. Dhanavats, pranams, all glories to Srila Prabhupada. I am very humbled to write an offering to you on the occasion of your 75th Vyasa Puja. Srila Prabhupada begins to write the introduction of the Bhagavad Gita as it is by quoting the Mangalacharana prayers. He writes, "I was born in the darkest ignorance, and my spiritual master opened my eyes with the torch of knowledge. I offer my respectful obeisances unto him." This verse is very applicable to me because when I entered this material world, I had no exposure to Krishna consciousness and was living in ignorance. It was your generosity of freely distributing this true and sacred knowledge of Krishna consciousness that picked me up from my fallen condition and made me aware of what my ultimate goal should be. Maharaj, you are a perfect Vaishnava and representative of Srila Prabhupada because you practice what you preach. There are many people who say something and do the opposite, but you are always leading by example. Whenever you take class, you always refer to Bhagavad Gita as it is, Srimad Bhagavatam, and Srila Prabhupada's books. From this experience, I have learned that one must simply follow the instructions of the spiritual master and speak only what the spiritual master has taught them. Srila Prabhupada has said in the preface of Bhagavad Gita that if personally I have any credit in this matter, it is only that I have tried to present Bhagavad Gita as it is without any adulteration. You are an example of this humble mood because you always make sure to repeat Srila Prabhupada's words by referring to his books. No matter rain or shine, you are always working in the farm, whether it is lovingly taking care of the cows, planting new seeds, or painstakingly removing each slug from the earth. This is all because of your vision to recreate Srila Prabhupada's motto, simple living and higher thinking. From your actions, I have learned that devotional service must be performed with perseverance, despite bodily or material conditions. It is easy for us to simply call off devotional service due to Maya's alluring trap, but you are always making devotional service your number one priority. In the food truck, you always want to make sure that everyone will get top-of-the-line prasadam that is fresh and wholesome. From this, I have learned that one must endeavor with determination for perfection in their devotional service. You always wake up before Mangalarti and chant your rounds in the morning. I have learned from your actions that Krishna consciousness is not some peripheral feel-good pursuit, but is the awakening of a deep spiritual lens which can only be developed through sincere discipline and regulated service. There are also countless other examples and situations of your life that we can take as an example and learn from, and all of them reinforce your constant action in devotional service. Thus, you live by Lord Krishna's ultimate instructions, man mana bhava mad bhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru mame vaishyasi satyam te pratijane priyosine. Always think of me, become my devotee, worship me, and offer your homage unto me. Thus, you will come to me without fail. I promise you this because you are my very dear friend. Bhagavad Gita, 18th chapter, 65th verse. Maharaj, I am so very thankful that you have given us your mercy as our spiritual master and guided us in our humble attempts to embark on the path of devotional service so that we may someday please Sri Sri Radha Neela Madhava, your ever humble servant, Shrestha.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Happy Krishna conscious birthday, Guru Maharaj. On this auspicious occasion, I would like to take a moment to express my gratitude to have your association. You have been a big influence in my life since I was a little child. Back then, I would look up to you as my grandpa, and last August, you went from my grandpa to my guru, so the connection was there right from the beginning. I remember like 16, 17 years ago, back in the little temple here, you were dressed up as Santa Claus, and I and a couple other kids were spying on you when you left the main temple hall to see if you were actually flying back on a sled or where you were going. But obviously, you were just going to change your clothes in the room. So it was my genius idea that day to say, if we pray to Santa Claus, we'll get more presents. And that's when you came out and you heard me and you were like, but if you pray to Krishna, you'll get whatever you want. Who cares about his little presents? So all of us kids sat there, and I'm pretty sure that was the first time I did like a full complete round at temple. Even though my intention was a little bit different, I still chanted. You know how to deal with people of all ages with the same smile and laugh on your face, which lightens up everyone's mood? I'm sure just by your merciful glance, anyone can become a devotee. Like, put Krishna consciousness aside for a moment. You're the reason my dad is even alive today and recovered from cancer all those years ago. Not only am I in Krishna consciousness today because of you, but I also have my family. No matter how much gratitude I show you, it'll never be enough. I really didn't think I deserved initiation at such a young age because of things that were happening at the beginning of college, but you still accepted me as your disciple and gave me the chance to improve myself. You continuously take care of everyone as if we're one family, and I felt that from the first time I entered the temple, even until right now. Thank you, Guru Maharaj. Please give me your blessing so that I may continue in the path of Krishna consciousness. I pray to Sri Sri Radha Neela Madhav that more people are fortunate enough to have your association and that you continue to accomplish your goals with good health. Your humble servant, Lakshmi Priya Devi Dasi.
Om Agyana Timirandhasya Gyananjana Shalakhaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Hari Vilas Maharajite Namine Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namine नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यातेशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे डियर गुरु महाराज प्लीज एक्सेप्ट आर हम्बल ओबेसेंसेस अनटू योर लोटस फीट आई एम नॉट इवन क्वालिफाइड टू राइट एन ऑफरिंग अनटू यू But because of your mercy and the mercy of all the devotees, I am able to. Thank you for accepting me as one of your servant. You have all the qualities that a pure devotee of the Lord may possess. But the one that stands out for me is your desire to serve the Lord and his devotees all the time. You are always engaged in serving the Lord faithfully. Every day you complete your rounds before Mangalarti and you are always reading Srila Prabhupada's book. I pray that I am able to achieve that someday. You are in the farm every day taking care of the cows. Because of your hard work in the farm, we got to relish fresh organic vegetables throughout the summer. I love hearing Srimad Bhagavatam from you every morning after Mangalarti, mostly online though. You play a major role in keeping the Seattle congregation together. Your presence makes us complete. Whenever you are not in Seattle, we miss you so much. Today morning, even Radhika Leela Mataji shared the same thing, that when Maharaj is not here, we feel so vacant. Our kids are so fortunate and blessed to have your association through the Bhagavad Gita classes you take. You are like a grandfather to all the kids here in Seattle. You are always there to solve everyone's problems. You have cooked scrumptious feast for all of us over all these years. In spite of spending hours cooking during the festival, you are still up and awake during Mangalarti. On your 75th Vyasa Puja, I request your mercy so that I can try to come to Mangalarti more often and attend your classes. Dear Guru Maharaj, I pray to Sri Sri Radha Neela Madhav Bhagwan to bestow you with the best of health so that you may continue to inspire many souls and fill their hearts with Krishna Prema and Krishna Seva. Hare Krishna, your servant, Ananda Manjari, Devidasi.
Om Adnana Timrayandasya Nananjaya Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Ena Tasmai Shri Gurve Nama Vancha Kalpatarubhecha Kripa Sindhu Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. Hare Krishna Maharaj, please accept our humble obeisance to your holy feet. Please forgive me if I have made any mistake because I am so insignificant to glorify what you have done so far for this community and our congregation. Maharaj, whenever I sing the Guru Ashtakam in Mangalarti, it reminds me that, and I remember you because you demonstrate all the qualities mentioned in the prayer. I can feel that every day in your association. We have one proverb in Marathi. Bole tesa chale tachi vandavi paule. It means like this. It goes like this. The person who has integrity between what he speaks and what he acts. And basically, so we should offer them obeisances or we should worship them. That person is basically deserved to be prayed. And that's what I feel personally and experience these many times since my association with the temple and seeing you demonstrating and teaching everyone every day by your exemplary acts of serving Prabhupada and Lord Krishna. Maharaj, you have demonstrated your versatile personality time to time in various front, from spirituality to business acumen you have. You use all possible ways of giving Krishna to everyone with different mindset, people of with different mindset, by emphasizing on Sankirtan, book distribution, prasadam distribution, organizing festivals, cow protection and farming, with attitude of giving back to community, while working tirelessly spreading Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's message and Prabhupada's movement by building community relationship with help of political and corporate leaders. Maharaj, you built this Seattle congregation from scratch. I can see how you are helping devotees solving their physical, emotional, mental and social day-to-day problems and providing guidance. I want to share one example actually. I mean, there may be many examples, but one of the examples, it touched me. So one of the lady actually was sharing, she's a devotee. I don't want to name her, but one day she literally crying when I asked her a question, like I have seen exchanging of her kids in the our Samamish library. And I asked her, Mataji, what happened? Like, why that lady came and you are exchanging? And then she started crying. But because there are some incidents happened and then they took custody of their kids and her husband has to leave the house. And they have a very big house in Samamish. But unfortunately, she is and her husband are not living together and they have to share that some days, few days to her and few days to, I mean, they're really going through very, very bad situation. And she was literally started crying and it like felt very, very bad. But she said that because of Maharaj, we are here. We could build the courage to stay here because Maharaj is here. Otherwise, we had almost shattered and broken out and we don't know what to do because this is a situation we are going through. We have no idea what to do and at this very moment Maharaj help us to find out and we get some courage to stay here. So this is just one example and maybe many other people have many other different experiences and examples. So you are in true sense source of inspiration to all, right from the kids to elders and everybody. So I pray Radha Nila Madhav for your good health and long life. So that we like a little bit selfish here, so that we get all of us, we get your association and blessing and guide us throughout our spiritual journey. Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Namo Om Vishnupadaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Shrimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namene Namaste Sarasvati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sanyavadi Pasyatya Deshatarine. Hare Krishna, Hare Vilas Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Every day in the morning, you give us a class on Srimad Bhagavatam. I find this extremely helpful because you tell us important points which we should apply in our everyday life. One thing I love about you is that you can understand knowledge from Bhagavad Gita as it is in Srimad Bhagavatam and quote a lot of different verses from various bona fide scriptures. Earlier, it was hard for me to wake up at 7, but now because of attending your classes, I learned that I am waking up at 5:30 and attending your classes. I am teaching one of my friends the 15th chapter slokas, and in the 5th verse, Nirmana Moha Chitta Sangha Dosa Adhyatma Nityavani Vritta Kama Dvandvair Vimukta Sukadukka Samnir Gacchanti Muda Padamavyayam Tat, which talks about being freed from the dualities of happiness and distress, being freed from false association, and being freed from false prestige. I was able to connect 3 verses without being prepared, and when they asked, I said that because of attending Harivilas Maharaj's classes, I was able to quote those verses. Those verses are Bhagavad Gita 2.14, Matra Sparshasta Kanteya, which talk about the dualities of happiness. Pranadapi Sunichena Tarapi Sahishnuna Amanina Manadena Kirtaniya Sadahari, which talks about the tree and the speck of grass. For the tree, it tolerates all the seasons. For the speck of grass, it's so humble that it accepts people stepping on it. And thank you, Maharaj, for your classes, and happy Krishna conscious birthday. I pray to Radha Neel Madhav to bestow you of good health, and we pray that you keep on giving these classes, and I pray that you keep on giving me your association.
Hare Krishna, all patients. I'm going to try to be brief because I don't think of myself as a good speaker. I encountered this practice through books, and then as I look back in my life, I've had elements of his products, the foot bath and some other things right before I showed up. I showed up originally at a Rath Yatra, but I couldn't get out of my car because I was in line trying to get through the light that took 10 minutes to get through. My first service was clean dishes. I was just a little scared, like, why should I touch these people's dishes? But that started me on understanding the point of the practice, at least part of it, that there's nothing like devotional service. You can do a lot of things in your life. Maybe you could become a president of a company, start one. I've been a part of one. You can have a family, a material family. You can have a lot of things, a lot of possessions, or like gone to great places. But there's nothing like not remembering fully what happened over the weekend, but knowing you were happy the entire time. Like picking up trash, being around a live band, people serving prasadam all day, and you're in and out of services here and there. There's nothing quite like devotional service. And when I first came here, I wanted to understand the practice, and I saw in book, more than one book, that devotional service is the point. And the book couldn't tell me what that meant until I came here. And so I just want to say that my two wishes are, or dreams, or hopes, or whatever, is that Maharaj is very patient with me when I don't understand something, or I make mistakes. I'm going to make a lot. And that he always keeps me in his service. There's nothing like service. There's nothing like it. Those are my two desires that everybody understands. That I when I got here, I gave up everything I could because I thought that's what I needed to do to survive, to figure this out. I gave up a job before I showed up. I took a job nearby to be here every day. I left that job because it had to deal with cows and their meat. I don't associate with most of my family, not because I don't want to, but because this is the family I like more. The service here is, there's just nothing like it. Once you taste something from it, you want to go deeper. And I miss the festivals. Maharaj can put on a really good festival. If you can bring your family, get everybody engaged for months for some people and days for others. But the one thing I can't say enough about Maharaj is he's been able to give me service, and I hope all of you taste that service and will hold on to it as hard as you can. Thank you very much, Maharaj. Thank you very much.
Vancha kalpatarubhyascha kripa sindubhyo eva cha patita naam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo nama. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, dandavat pranam. Please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Maharaj, this is my I feel this is a very auspicious day because I am getting an opportunity to say something about my Guru Maharaj. I'm not sure whether I'll be able to put into words or, you know, do justice to how I feel about you. But I think words will fall short. But all I want to say is that whenever I have interacted with you, I have always found you to be so full of compassion. And that is one quality, Maharaj, which has always, you know, gotten me, felt me connected to you. And whenever I have written a script here, but I am just, you know, not using it, but I just want to wish you a very happy Krishna Conscious Appearance Day, and I pray to Sri Sri Radha Nila Madhav for your very long, healthy and happy life, material life and spiritual life. And Guru Maharaj, the more, as I said, you know, the more I have come to know you and the more I felt connected to Krishna. So I feel that this is a magic of Krishna's devotee, which you are. Because without your association, I do not think that I would have been where I am right now. This is all attributed to me, my husband and my family getting associated to you, is that why we are here today. Guru Maharaj, without knowing much about me, you took me under your shelter. So, you know, as I said, you know, you are so full of compassion, and I have always seen you, like, you know, few occurrences when I have done service in, you know, closer proximity to you, I have always seen you treating everybody fairly and equally. Doesn't matter whether you have known them for a long time or whether you are meeting them for the first time. So when I look at the qualities a Krishna's favorite devotee should possess, my heart tells me that you might be one of Krishna's favorite devotee. So I am so glad that I am in your association. One other thing I wanted to say is that that, you know, you have so much faith in your spiritual master, and that always gives me so much inspiration and hope. That you are trying to bring each and every individual soul, like as many people as possible, closer to Krishna, even the younger generation, so that they can carry this movement forward and you know, this lineage can continue. So I feel so much hopeful for the future, and your tireless and selfless service with utmost diligence and so much attention to detail you have, it's just amazing. It's a source of inspiration for all of us. And I have so much to learn from you, and so I long for your continuous association so that you know, I can continue to learn. And being a fallen soul like me, I beg your mercy, and you know, please forgive all my offenses, you know, knowingly, unknowingly, I commit, you know, and please continue to shower your merciful glance on us, like my family, so that we can move forward in this journey of Krishna consciousness. Thank you so much, Maharaj. Thank you, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, Dandavat Pranam, all glories to Srila Prabhupada. Please accept my humble obeisances. Maharaj, I am not going to say more than what Janani has already said. But one thing which I wanted to say is, like, if me and my family can get 0.001% of your dedication, devotion, determination, and your tenacity to do things, and as Janani was saying, your attention to detail, you do things so meticulously. So if we can get even 0.01%, Maharaj, we will think that we have been successful in our life, following your preachings, following your practices, following your direction, following your guidance. So my also my sincere request, Maharaj, is I do not get much chance to serve you, Maharaj. So if you can shower your blessings and show your mercy to give us the opportunity to do more service, where we are able to serve the mission of Srila Prabhupada and at the same time follow your direction and your guidance. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj.
All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. I came into ISKCON, I think around like 10 years ago. And from the day I came in, even though I don't have much interaction with you, I could sense that connectivity. Whether it is good or bad, I always come to you for any decisions or any suggestions. And you always guided me and my family, just like my father. And I really want to have much more longing association and a good health for you. I appreciate it a lot. And I wish you a very Krishna conscious happy birthday, Maharaj. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Maharaj, happy 75th Krishna Conscious Birthday. You are here like our father and spiritual father, and you have been in this Krishna Conscious movement more than 50 years. I'm close to 50 years, I'm just starting my spiritual journey by your mercy. I have been coming to temple many years, but not very serious about spiritual life, coming and doing some work and going. And I just want to say, couple of things, and one, usually I used to go to Sankirtan along with you and other people and do some bread distribution and take some pictures. That's what I used to do. And one time Maharaj stopped Kirtan and came to me and say, distribute books. I was surprised. Why did Maharaj come and say that? Maharaj never said anything and say, okay, he stopped the Kirtan and came to me and say, okay, to distribute books. I was surprised and say, okay, then was not feeling very confident, but started book distribution and talking to people about Krishna and other things. And eventually Maharaj is so merciful that Maharaj initiated me in the holy land of Lord Chaitanya's birthplace and gave me the name Krishna Chaitanya Das. Indefinitely indebted you for your mercy. Hopefully by your mercy I should be able to do something for the community in Krishna, to get in for the Krishna Conscious movement. Otherwise I should be miserable. And that one thing, and I just want to say what's so special about Harivilas Maharaj. So we see many Maharajas, they say they are very good at Kirtan, they are very good at giving classes and very good at book distribution. And here, what do we have here? Maharaj works a whole day in the farm and comes back to temple and do ecstatic kirtan. And he goes to food truck and talk to all these fallen homeless people and comes back, wonderful lecture. And like this, the unique thing is like it's a servitude. So we have everything plus the service. That's like it's uncompromised. There is no compromise. So you can see any of his Maharaj disciples also, they are not any lazy bums. That servitude comes from Maharaj. It's like it's built in. Thank you so much, Maharaj. It's like guiding us in this Krishna conscious movement so uniquely, and we are very, very fortunate to have your association. And I just want to end with one thing, saying how this saintly holy people like Harivilas Maharaj, they don't even notice their influence on the material world. So few years back I was with one of the meetings with the GBC people came, and I was in the one of the meetings, and they are saying, oh, Seattle is always raining, do you get any sunshine here? And I said, I immediately said, yes, but when Maharaj goes out for Sankirtan, we do get sunshine, I said. And they said, yeah, we heard about it. But immediately Maharaj protested, no, that's not true. But I did not agree with that. Then immediately on next weekend, we went out for Sankirtan, and it was raining. And Maharaj came out of the car and started Sankirtan. Immediately sun came out. Even Maharaj was wondering, looking at sun, is it right? they don't even notice, pay attention to these details, but as we grow up with Maharaj, looking at all these things, we just want to mention so that we get some purification, that's all, nothing else. Thank you so much, Maharaj. We pray Radha Leela Madhava, Jagannath Babu Subhadra, Gauranitai, Lakshmi Narasimha Dev, Sitaram Lakshman Bhagavan, Bhakti Raman, and Prabhupada to give you long life, good health, to support us and to guide us in this whole community in the Krishna conscious movement. Thank you so much, Maharaj. Hare Krishna. Want
to say something? My Dandavat Pranams to Guru Maharaj, Lotus Feet. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. I offer my humble obeisances to you, Maharaj. You are fulfilling Prabhupada's mission by establishing temples and goshala, farm, books, distribution, serving prasadam, and bringing people in Krishna's bhakti. As Lord's representative, as doctor, father, guru, you are helping all the devotees. That you, Maharaj, for all your inspiration, thank you, Maharaj, for all your inspiration. Four years ago, when I came to Seattle, I got introduced to chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, and with your blessings, I started chanting. During our visit this time, I came to know about the importance of Guru, and you accepted me as disabled. Because of mercy of devotees and Krishna, I don't know if I have the qualification, but it's my good fortune that I got a guru like you. I want to share recent incident that happened few months ago. Jewelry got stolen from our house in India. I don't feel much, thinking it's Krishna's plan with your guidance. I would see the change in me under your guidance, and I was peaceful without any worry. With your guidance, I read Srimad Bhagavatam once, and reading Bhagavad Gita daily, and chanting in early hours, and attending service in temple. Please give your blessings so that I can always follow in your footsteps and advance in Krishna consciousness by engaging in devotional service. I pray to the Lordships to give your strength, health, long life, and to engage, inspire more people in Krishna consciousness and fulfills Prabhupada's mission. Please forgive any offenses I commit knowingly and unknowingly. Your humble servant, Rameshwari, Krishna, Dandavat Pranamam.
नमस्कार प्रभु जी, हरे राम हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। प्रभु जी महाराज, वी आर वेरी ग्रेटफुल टू यू सर, बिकॉज आई टुक इन 2009 this Sai Sevak Diksha in India. At that time, my wife also came, but my Guruji, he did not given to her, but he given to me. So why that time he refused? Because after now, I think this is the place to take Diksha that is higher than our guru, that is Shirdi Sai Baba. Without Krishna, no Sai Baba is there, no God is there. Only Krishna is the main. So we are feeling like that. Every day we are even in we are giving harati, we say Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare, even in Sai Baba harati also. Without Krishna, there is no Sai Baba harati. So, this is the place to take her, this Diksha, Krishna Diksha, because she is more than me now, because I am below his rank. Because I will go to Krishna through Sai Baba, but she went already through you, Krishna, because she is doing, she is, every day she is reading Bhagavad Gita and praying Krishna and Prabhuji. So, and also we have to go India actually in November 2019, but I don't know why we are here. Because Krishna and yourself, you are. Both of you to stay here, because you don't go India, there is a corona is there, so you be here safely. So I think we are here, and she also took Diksha here, so we are very thankful, and we are doing service also in temple.
She took Diksha, you have to take Shiksha.
Yes. I won't take Shiksha, because I will get all blessings through her, Krishna's blessings and your blessings through her.
You also need Shiksha.
And you have given very good service here in kitchen, and I am doing every, if I come here, I will do serving for food. That is the, my Guruji told, wherever you go, you give some, do some service to me also. So same thing we took here, because of your grace and Krishna's grace and my Baba grace. So we are very thankful to you, sir. And your blessings always has with us for throughout our life. My daughter is here, my son also in Chicago, he also following Krishna's consciousness. So only my elder son is in India, but he won't do anything, but he will go to temple, but he's not in this mood. So you bring him also in this, in your language, that's go to. Okay, but Krishna, blessings and your blessings. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prastaya Bhutale Srimata Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namine. Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine. Dear Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisance. All glories to Srila Prabhupada, all glories to you on this auspicious day of your Vyasa Puja. You possess the ocean of virtuous qualities. Your unflinching faith in the holy name, unconditional devotion to Prabhupada's mission, leading this congregation on the spiritual journey, and your simplicity are some of them. You show us how practicing and leading a spiritual life is simple if one has faith in Prabhupada's instructions. You are the fabric that binds this congregation together. Your humility and modesty, despite your vast knowledge of Shastras, are exemplary. You are an epitome of kindness and love. We are ever indebted to you for giving us shelter at your feet and your causeless mercy in showing us the path of our spiritual journey. As I look back at the events of the last couple of years in our life, I see how your mercy has played such a critical role. When my wife was dealing with a huge loss of her father passing away, you provided the emotional support of her father at a place far away from home. As we were planning to buy our abode or our home, you gave us subtle hints to move near the temple. During our house hunting, all roads led to the residential areas near the temple, and we moved close by. Your timely nudge as we deviated from the path helped us to bring us back on track. You give us advice when we need the most. You are always present for us. It is like we have the protection of Krishna through you. You gave us shelter at your holy feet. For neophyte devotees like us, you build this congregation to take care of us. Thank you for giving us such a wonderful God family. On my personal front, you showed me the way on how to serve Krishna by playing the mridanga. You provided multiple opportunities to accompany you during different kirtans and experience the bliss as you render your devotion to Krishna. Thanks for being such a pillar in our life and our community. May Radha Neela Madhav shower you with countless blessings. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Hari Vilas Maharaj Swami ki jai. Your humble servant Sukriti Krishna Das and Supriya Radha Devi Das.
Pranam Guru Maharaj, Janmadinara Hartika Suvecha. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Guru Maharaj, I really wanted to say so many things. I wanted to write them, but yesterday, whenever I sat down, I started crying. I don't know why, I know why, but I couldn't write anything. And when I heard everybody saying so many things about you, I just would like to repeat them year after year after year after, as long as I could. And when I first came here in the temple and I saw you, so people have said you are very simple, but how simple you are, I have experienced that. When I saw you first time, I thought he's just a nobody. A person like in India, in the temple, old man, he is working here so that he will get some food to eat and will survive like that. And I felt very pity on you. And I came, had the darshan, and I prayed, Krishna, please take care of this old man. From that old man to my Guru Maharaj, long journey. You blessed me like my father would know. When I was in grief, ocean of grief, you kept your head on my head. Nobody would do that other than my father would do it. I cannot ever repay you. I have to chant more so that I can control my emotions. I'm just an emotional mess, especially whenever I think about him. So that I can be a good example. When people will see me, they will think about my Guru Maharaj. I want to work on that. Bless me for that. And next time again, I will say more. Jagannath will keep you healthy always. That's what I pray. Hari Bol.
Om Gyanat Mayan Jasya Gyanan Jala Shalakiya Taksha Olitam Yena Tashmai Sri Guru Namaha. Happy Krishna Conscious Birthday Guru Maharaj. Shri Prabhupada Ki Jai. Patitivan Ki Jai.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, Happy Krishna Conscious Birthday Guru Maharaj, Dandavat Pranam, Jai Srila Prabhupada. Maharaj, we are very, very thankful to you for nourishing us every day with your classes, with your instructions, and by leading your example and showing us how to render the practical devotional service. And you are very merciful every day. You are giving your mercy every day to everyone. And there are a few examples that I want to just share, like your morning Bhagavatam classes, that every single day you are taking out the time to nourish us. And these, as you say, these are our daily inoculation. And with your and Krishna's mercy, I am able to attend them, and I can see how this inoculation is working. And with my small little observation, this is giving me some clarity to my thoughts little by little. It's just giving some clarity every day, little by little. I can experience that as you are explaining in your daily classes. So this is your one of your daily mercy upon us. You're giving daily morning blessings. And second thing is, you're leading by example. This is another mercy upon us, that you're showing how to render the practical devotional service. So one of the things that I most attracted is, like, when you're working in the farm, this year I got little chance with your mercy to go to farm. And when I see how much hard work you are doing there from years and years, I did not realize that earlier. This year I realized that how much hard work you are doing there every single day. And your attention to the detail is like how deep you are cleaning even the cow dung from the to the in the barn every single day. It is just like a practical example for me, like how I should try. And another, your mercy is the food truck, that you, not just this community, you take care of our surrounding, all the other people as well, those are not able to come to temple. You want to reach there and give your mercy and Krishna's prasadam to them, so that they will get purified. I will just take another minute. And another thing I've seen as your mercy is, when you went to the India last year, and I have seen you have not taken enough rest in between your all the days. You were just continuously giving your mercy one after another place. You keep traveling, and very little rest and continuous programs. And one of the example I would share, the day you traveled from here to Chennai, you have reached to the Prabhu's house around like 4 a.m. and it was very long and tiring travel, like around 24 hours. And as soon as you reached there, and you got ready for the Mangal Aarti, and you just did the Mangal Aarti, and now just after Mangal Aarti you gave the Srimad Bhagavatam class. So I was, that instant got just registered in my brain, like it's almost a year, and it just every day drinks in my ear, that how determined and how merciful you are, that you have not taken any rest at that time, and you just gave the you did the Mangal Aarti and you gave the class. So, and another thing, during that trip I have observed every single day there were so many Bhagavatam class. Wherever devotee sits, you are giving the class. And that changed my perspective. I earlier also I was inclined, but by taking every day these many classes, that changed my perspective one more level deeper, that how important these discussion and this Srimad Bhagavatam classes are. And one more thing I would share, like everywhere when we visit in India, I have seen like every single place the devotees has so much love for you, so much love, respect, and a lot they have shared about you. And especially in the Tiruchendur, I would say I personally experienced something different, that just my personal feeling. You did many programs there, like in the college with the college students. And everything was very ecstatic, everything. That classroom still rings bell in my ear, that there were more than 1,000 plus students there, and every single student was jumping or chanting with you in the kirtan. It was so ecstatic. And then in the evening you gave the program in the Tiruchendur with the congregation. That was so ecstatic, and the class is so ecstatic. And the way you were dancing, and you have not taken rest, but continuously you are so active and giving mercy to everyone. And immediately next day you did initiation program, and then immediately after initiation I was thinking now you will take some rest. It's like almost 3 p.m. But immediately after that you went for the Nagar Sankirtan, and you spent couple hours there on the road for the Nagar Sankirtan. Every single activity was so ecstatic, full of energy. And this is your mercy to every single person. And please please forgive me for any mistakes that I have done or any offenses, and with your mercy, please bless us, so we will be able to listen your every single class and follow your instructions. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. A very happy Krishna conscious birthday to you. Guru Maharaj, we have not seen Prabhupada, but we are seeing him, his glories, and hearing him through you. We have not seen him, but all the lectures that you are giving, all the kirtans, we are doing all that through you. Guru Maharaj, you are like a father to me. Whenever I feel I am disturbed in my mind, or I am in a problem, or I need advice, I think of coming to you. Earlier, I used to call my parents if there was a problem. Now I don't feel like calling them for any problem. It's just I am always in a state of bliss. Like they say, when you surrender to Krishna, there is no fear, no anxiety. I am feeling that bliss by coming every day now to the two temple, by doing darshan. So like in Hindi they say bhakti mein maza aane laga hai. So that bliss I am feeling every day by looking at you, by coming, doing darshan. I try and your principle, I always try to remember that when in doubt, ask Diksha Guru and Shiksha Guru. I try to always remember that. Through your lectures, I have learned how to be determined in service, how to be enthusiastic always, and do your service, be humble towards the devotees. I had no quality of becoming your disciple, but you accepted me. Thank you, Guru Maharaj. Please bless me so that I can raise my kids in the Krishna consciousness, and I pray on this special day to Shri Shri Radha Neela Madhava for your good health and protection. Thank you, Guru Maharaj. Thank you.
Om Agyanatimirandasya Gyananjana Salakaya Chakshur Namilitam Jena Tasma Shri Gurave Namaha. Nama Om Shnupadaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutare Shmar Bhakti Viranta Swaminiti Namine. Namaste Saraswati Devam Gaurvani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunavari Pasatari Shatarine. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutari Shmati His Holiness Hari Vilas Maharaj Goswami Ki Jai. So, Maharaj, from the depth of my heart, from the core of my heart, I would like first to wish you a happy Transcendental Appearance Day. So many things I can try to express, but we don't have time. And I'm going to speak the essential. I would like to deeply express my utmost gratitude for everything He has done in my life. And I can't even explain it, because from the very beginning of my Krishna consciousness, You guided me. You gave me protection. This back to Paris. I knew Krishna consciousness in the late 70s, but when I decided to become full-time, and then I had this opportunity, and inconceivable opportunity to associate with you, it was not for very long, but you always impressed me at that time. And up until today, you continue to impress me. Why? Because I see in you all the qualities of true devotee, true Vaishnava, like humility, simplicity, dedication to one's own spiritual master, following strictly the order of spiritual master. You have all these things in you. That's what impressed me the most. Your humility, your love for everyone. These are true qualities of a Vaishnava. So in my Krishna consciousness, you have played an amazing role. I met my spiritual master because of you. And because of you, you're my Siksha Guru then. And then you recommended me for initiation. Because at that time, you were not initiating. I said, well, he actually approached you. This was Mayapur. And, so you said, I cannot initiate you. But you recommended me to a Vaishnava that I was attracted to. And you encouraged me to do so. So in this way, you've been playing a very important role in my spiritual life. And after years and years, again, here I am, under your shelter, under your protection, under your guidance. And you're giving me every day the most gifts, much less gift every day. And the way you speak on Bhagavatam, Krishna Katha, this is the greatest treasure, greatest gift you can give to someone. And so many other things, of course, but I would really today, this most auspicious day of your divine appearance, I would like genuinely to express this gratitude towards you. Next, to conclude, I would like to, for the pleasure of the Vaishnavas, devotees, I quote some Shastra, because today is not ordinary day. Today is Vyasa Puja. It's no ordinary birthday. We should know this very well. We're not here to celebrate so-called birthday. This is Vaishnava Appearance Day. It's known as Vyasa Puja. Because I didn't have anybody mention that, but of course they know it. But I would like just to bring to the everybody's awareness. This is related to Guru Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva. And we should understand. It is said in Shastra, Acharama Vijanyam Navamanyeta Karichit Namartya Buddhya Suyate Sarvadeva Maya Gurum. We should understand that this Lord Krishna speaks to Uddhava. Uddhava, Krishna says, know the Acharya to be as good as myself. Here Acharya means spiritual master. Spiritual master is known in Vedic tradition Acharya because he teaches by example. So Krishna says, one should know Acharya as good as myself, never disrespect him, never envy him or consider him an ordinary man, for he is the sum total of all the demigods. So, and it says, further it is said, Guru Krishna Rupa Hana Shastriya Praman, Guru Rupe Krishna Krupa Korena Bhakta Gane. According to the Shastra, the Guru is non-different from Krishna because it is through the Guru that Krishna bestows mercy upon his devotees. So that's what we experience today. We're celebrating the appearance day of the spiritual master. So we should know this and meditate on this and always remember the spiritual master is the most intimate associate of the Supreme Lord, and the mercy of the Supreme Lord is received through him. No other way. It's a downward filtration. So Maharaj, time is very short. And again, I would like to say thank you so much for everything you've done in my life. And you've been always my model from the beginning and here today. You know, again, I'm with you. So I don't know Krishna arranges in this way, but again and again, I express my deepest gratitude. Thank you so much. And continue to just to guide me and protect me. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. All Guru Sri Srila Prabhupada, please accept our humble obeisances. I'm not very good at expressing myself. I'll be very short. I just want to thank you, Maharaj, and wish you a happy birthday, 75th birthday. And I just want to thank you that, you know, I remember our life before coming to Krishna consciousness. We'll be roaming around in malls and stores and wasting our time at a lot of places. But this temple gave us a lot of knowledge and a path or and a framework, and always admire you that, you know, we come across many different situations, but you give a framework that we can apply. I remember one thing is, long back you said, like, when you're making decision, you should think of whether this will take you towards Krishna or away from Krishna. So that has helped me a lot in many situations, and I've seen the impact of that in our personal life. I know we have long way to go and follow your instructions and fully surrender, and we're doing our best. And you know, thank you for, you know, providing all this environment here. You know, especially, you know, I was visiting farm earlier, but since COVID started, I got more involved and starting to feel love for the cows. And you know, it's very different experience that I'm going through. So you know, it's not possible without your vision. I remember the first day when Narayan and Lakshmi came and they ran away, and then all the devotees were running around, and now we have 9 cows there and they're all happy and they don't want to go anywhere, you know, just says. So thank you for all that, Maharaj, and you know, please continue your shelter and blessings so we can follow Krishna consciousness and your instructions. Krishna would like to say something.
Hare Krishna Maharaj, happy Vyas Puja, 75th Vyas Puja. So I cannot thank you enough. You transformed a mere hut on a parking lot to one of the most successfully growing rapidly growing ISKCON temples, saving so many fallen souls, proving that everything can be used in the service of Krishna with the right mindset. You put in so much to follow Srila Prabhupada's footsteps by many new projects under the temple, like Anand Mela and other festivals, projects at the farm for cow protection outreach, and the free food truck. Most people dismiss the idea of the food truck as just an idea, but you took that idea to reality. There's now a free food truck serving 5 times a week in Seattle and other places. Seeing how you make so many unachievable feats become a reality, I can look forward to a time where free food trucks are as common as UPS trucks. You put so many efforts day and night to helping us kids advance in Krishna consciousness. Since the time we came to temple, you have been there with all of us. Just like a grandfather, you tell us intriguing stories with a Krishna conscious moral to it. The countless morning classes you hold have helped me adapt and deal with the real world, helped me stop saying and interesting knowledge from the scriptures. My favorite parts of the classes are diving deep into false concepts like the Big Bang Theory and Darwin's Theory. It amazes me how much a deeper look into them exposes all of their ludicrous arguments that are structured by these fancy misleading words and then other forms of trickery. On your 75th Vyas Puja, I want to thank you for everything you've done.
Chicanery.
Huh?
Chicanery. That's trickery.
Trickery? What? Did I say true? Okay. Sorry, Maharaj. On your 75th Vyas Puja, I want to thank you for everything you've done and are doing for all of us. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. I wrote papers and pages to read, but I would just say, Guru Maharaj, you are everything. I cannot imagine a day morning without seeing you. Hare Krishna.
Om Ajnana Timirandas Jnananjana Salakaya Sakshuram Anvilitamena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Namaha Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Tinamine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharavine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Prashaiti Deshatarine Dhanam Mulam गुरुमूर्ति पूजमूलम गुरुर्पदम मंत्रमूलम गुरुर्वाक्यम मोक्षमूलम गुरुकृपा द ट्रांसलेशन द गुरु फॉरम इज द बेस्ट टू मेडिटेट अपॉन द गुरुज फीट आर द बेस्ट फॉर वर्शिप द गुरुज वर्ल्ड इज द मंत्र द गुरु ग्रेस इज द रूट ऑफ लिबरेशन प्लीज एक्सेप्ट माई हम्बल ऑबेसेंसेस ऑल ग्लोरीज टू श्रील प्रभुपाद ऑल ग्लोरीज टू यू महाराज ऑन द ऑस्पिशियस डे ऑफ योर व्यास पूजा बिकॉज ऑफ कृष्णा मर्सी एंड यूर ब्लेसिंग्स वी गॉट कनेक्टेड टू द राइट पाथ इन अवर लाइफ टुवर्ड्स कृष्णा consciousness. Before coming to Seattle, we had a very little knowledge about the difference between material and spiritual life. My condition especially, I was born in the darkest ignorance. Maharaj, you opened my eyes with the torch of knowledge. I offer my respectable obeisances. Initially, we started to come to our temple for our daughter's Sunday class. We got connected. When we started listening your lectures, it was a life-changing experience for me and for my family. We learnt a lot, the real meaning of and the purpose of our life. Still, we need to learn a lot. We are learning every day. Please forgive us for all our mistakes that we do unknowingly, as we are fallen soul, Maharaj. Maharaj, whenever we meet, you are always cheerful and openly accept all devotees, whether they are new to the congregation or they are very senior devotees or a Vaishnavas, but you accept in everyone in the same platform. That's a good quality what I see you every day, because I am observing from past 5 to 6 years where you meet new devotees, you give so much love. That's why they are able to come back again to the temple. That's the biggest thing I see you. In fact, I used to I always feel that I should learn that quality, how to interact with people with humbleness. I always remember you whenever I meet you. I should be like humble like you. Always, please help us. Please help me to make that kind of a person for me. Also, Maharaj, whenever we meet, you are always cheerful and openly accept. That's one more good quality. And as per Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 3, Chapter 25, Text 21, Prabhupada translate very well, the symptom of a sadhu or that he is a tolerant, merciful and friendly to all living beings. He has no enemies. He is peaceful, he is abates by the scripture, and all his characters are sublime. Whenever we review this, whenever we read this Srimad Bhagavatam, we remember you because you show all these qualities, Prabhu. We are blessed to have your association. Please guide us, your thoughtfulness, and please, whenever we encounter that where we came, whether it's a right decision to come to Seattle or whether it's a right decision to come to US, always we feel only one thing: yes, we came to a right place, that to Seattle. Maharaj is there. Because of Maharaj, yes, we are able to survive here. Otherwise, it's very difficult to leave, especially in this place. Thank you, Maharaj, for all these things, whatever you have given me an opportunity. And also I can quote here, whenever I do finance related work to the temple, it's not only in the devotion, how you manage even in the day-to-day operations, so tactically and so much calm you explain. Even that is also a big art. It's not a simple thing, because I interact a lot with our material team day-to-day in my office. But the way you interact is totally different, Maharaj. I definitely can make out. And that learning I am carrying and I am actually implementing in my office also. So that, in fact, 5 years back, people were not much helpful to talk with me. Now in the office also people like me a lot because of, all learned because of you, Maharaj, how to deal with people respectfully. Thank you, Maharaj, for your all service. Please bless us, and I am looking for your service more and more, and please give us the opportunity to serve. Thank you, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna, Maharaj. Jai Srila Prabhupada. All glories to you, Maharaj. This is my first time talking. I'm like, I have many things to say, but when I sit here, I like go blank. But I'm like so happy to be in your guidance. I dare to come here and say thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you very much. But Vaishnavi was so happy to come and talk to here today, but she could not make it. She was feeling very sad, so she requested us to read her thoughts to you. Please hear it, Maharaj. Happy Krishna conscious birthday, Maharaj. When what can I start, where can I start, Maharaj? You have impacted my family and my life so much. I remember a time you were doing service for Janmashtami, and it was midday and there were not many devotees around, just some kids talking. That was when I noticed that you were carrying big heavy boxes and moving heavy loads of furniture. I knew that you were already doing Nirjal Ekadashi and had already done a very strenuous ecstatic kirtan during Mangalarati, and at that point I just stood there amazed, not knowing where you had all this energy from. But as I slowly watched you service, I realized the answer. I saw how dedicated and focused you were working, Maharaj. You were servicing so well with only, I felt, I think in your mind, you must be thinking, I'm doing this for Krishna with all your heart. And that was when I realized and really understood in practical life the message, prayer and service to Krishna, unconditional love, and Krishna will take care of you. Like this, Maharaj, you are a true inspiration, as you always lead by example. Like this, you embody many more teachings of what a devotee should be like and show me that it is possible. I am so thankful, Maharaj, for giving me the opportunity to associate and learn from you, your servant Vaishnavi.
All glories to Srila Prabhupada, all glories to you, Maharaj. For me, we read so many books, but we always think what examples we have, what for what we read. Because most of the examples we read about are in Bhagavatam, are Ambarish Maharaj, Prahlad Maharaj, Dhruva Maharaj, who seem to be very impractical or not able to follow in this Kali Yuga, because those are very exalted devotees. So whenever people ask, is there anybody actually can do this kind of thing in the in this particular yuga, I have your examples. How you actually utilize your time, how you actually do activities, how you engage people in doing the service. Essentially every minute you live, something you want to do for Krishna as per the instructions given by your Guru Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada. So even when we get an opportunity to explain Bhagavad Gita in our classes, I don't need to look elsewhere to look for an example. So it always from my mouth it comes, Harilas Maharaj did this, Harilas Maharaj did this, he's planning to do this. So it's very easy to people to relate. So having the books is good, reading the books is good. But having somebody following that, and every word by word, verse by verse, living through that every moment, is what actually excites people and take up Krishna consciousness. So that's what, right from the day one when I got attracted, you know that I've seen you and you are my first guru, spiritual leader who I interacted with. And it's not, I didn't read Bhagavad Gita before that in detail. It's just based on your behavior, your exemplary actions, and that's what attracted. And I still remember when the temple was small here, I just joined around that time. And when he proposed Anand Mela and all this thing, there's a lot of resistance. And then that becomes successful, Kumbh Mela, the first Kumbh Mela. And then when he said this, when we build this temple, we should fill this temple with people. And that also, like knowing the number of people we get, is it possible? That happened. Then one Mela become 10 other Melas. Now temple we cannot even accommodate on Janmashtami day, so many people. And it has grown a lot, and all, in all spheres, like preaching and Melas and taking care of the deities, deity standards also have gone up. So many things are happening. So what we thought that time is probably one goal we all probably can achieve successfully. Now we have many goals. We have Bellevue project, we have farm project, we have the school project here, and we are planning to do many, many things. So now we all have to at least have the belief strongly that these things will happen because you are behind them. Our goal is to help you in whichever way, little way. People can give time, their resources, their life, activities. There are so many activities for all of us. So we can actually practically work any number of activities which you want to. So thank you for engaging all of our time in actually at least discharging the devotional service by your examples, seeing you as an example. So with that, and I also see that you are 75 and you are much more younger than all of us in all the services. We cannot compete with you. You are doing all the services when the temple was small. Now same service is still doing it. Now each of the service you, because of your behavior and exemplary behavior, we actually attracted so many committed devotees who actually took up these services. And I'm sure these things will continue because they are very committed. I can see them in action. Example, Mukunda Prabhu. When everybody is shutting down, he actually expanded the food truck program. Right? So these are not ordinary souls. You brought us here. Just like Srila Prabhupada said, his Guru Maharaj sent all the his assistants to serve him. You also, your Guru Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada, actually sent all of these great devotees to help you to spread the Krishna consciousness. I truly request the activities which you started, the methodology which you follow to spread Krishna consciousness does not limit only to Seattle. It should go all over the world. We are already doing that in India, within North America, and various other places. People should take these examples and expand Srila Prabhupada movement to the greatest extent possible. That should be the only goal. And you are 75, you are not thinking about retiring, going to Vrindavan, Mayapur. We don't hear those things from you. You say wherever devotee is there, service is there, that is Vrindavan. And that's what Srila Prabhupada explained also in Nectar of Instruction. So you are actually living that example here, setting us the goal. So we all have to, instead of thinking I'll go to some other place to do something better, then stay here and do much, much better. And for Sri Radha Neela Madhava. So with that, I pray to Srila Prabhupada to give you many, many years ahead here with health and all the resources which you need so that you can do the service here very nicely for many years to come to set us an example and inspire us more and more in doing the same thing. Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Hare Krishna, Arulas Maharaj, the humble devotees, Arun Krishna Das and Padmana Lakshmi Devi Dasi, please accept our humble obeisances, all gurus to Srila Prabhupada. Thank you so much. We wish you a very, very blessed, happy Vyasa Puja. They'd asked me to share some offering for this Vyasa Puja. And I have so many stories to talk about you. I've never done this before. So one thing I remember distinctly is the first time to the temple. I was newly married. And His Grace Vedanarayan Prabhu called me to the temple. I came there. That day there was a huge birthday party. And Your Grace, you were actually picking up the garbage trash bags. And I was gorging on the prasadam. There was cake, there was gulab jamun, there was pizza. And I thought, who's this guy who's picking up the trash, right? And then Vedanarayan Prabhu said, he is the main guy in the temple. So I couldn't believe my eyes. The next time I saw you, you were doing Homa for the end of the Damodar month for people to break their fast. And I couldn't believe an international person chanting the Vedic mantras so nicely. I was impressed. You showed us how to serve the lotus feet of Sri Sri Radhani and Madhava. So many trips on the food trucks. And you are a great expert in working the fryer. I never knew, never could learn how to get it going. And then you gave me the sound audio service, which I was fortunate. I could hear so many great devotees come and speak in the temple on my headphones. You recognized, you were able to overlook our faults. We're all still faulty, but we still try. You have set up a great example for us. And there was never a time I've seen you talk about Srila Prabhupada without tears in your eyes. And you have presented Srila Prabhupada to us as it is. And I cannot thank you enough for you having accepted us as your honored disciples. And we hope to meet your expectations someday. And we are trying hard. I don't know what else to say, Maharaj. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna, Maharaj. Our humble obeisances to you. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. And wish you a very happy Vyasa Puja. And thank you for blessing us with Krishna consciousness. And please pray for our advancement in Krishna consciousness. And I still remember about the kirtans we used to do in the temple in Seattle. Thank you for all the encouragement you have been doing, and we'll try our best with your blessings to advance in Krishna consciousness. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, Dandvat Pranam. This is Nirmala Prema Devi Dasi. Happy Krishna Conscious Birthday, Guru Maharaj. I am very thankful to you for accepting as your disciple. I am very always getting inspired as you are leading by example. You are showing us how to do practical devotional service by your hard work in farm, in outside, festival, in temple. You are helping everyone by answering their queries, questions, doubts. Guru Maharaj, every time you prepare Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year, and many more feasts, that your special mercy upon us. Please bless us, Guru Maharaj, so I will become sincere and serious in sadhana and follow your instruction. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. The following is an offering of His Grace Sitapati Prabhu from Thachanur for glorification of His Holiness Harivilas Prabhu Maharaj on His Vyasa Puja celebration day.
Hare Krishna Tandavat Pranam Prabhu. Harivilas Prabhu ke inade Tandavat Pranam.
Hare Krishna, I would like to offer my humble dandavats to Harivilas Prabhu.
Pakistan the Maharajone Kudumbatla and the Pakistan the Maharajone Kudumbatla Engluko Kedangarajurge Aprinanikimus Rumba Anandamarke.
We are very delighted to know that we have been given a place in the family of His Holiness Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj Srila Prabhupada.
Prabhupada udaya kodain kila naangal irukom appingumbodhu adhu romba aanandama irukke adhe samayathila Harivilas Prabhu marakka mudiyuma.
We are very happy to know that we are under the umbrella of Srila Prabhupada. At the same time, Harivilas Prabhu, how can I forget?
And the Nalkala Maraka Mudima Adavadi Krishna, even the Nalkala Vida, Krishna and the Volagata Vite, Pona Kapadan, the Kobi Rumba, the government of Priyam Kuduna Mari, Nanga Kobi Rukila, Nanga Naida.
How can I forget those days? Just like the gopis felt the love for Krishna when he left than when he was present, we are not gopis, we are dogs. But however,
anala and Harivilas Prabhu enga kude irunda naalkal ovvor naalkal muttu muttana naalkal.
The days when Harivilas Prabhu stayed with us, each day is like a pearl in the days.
அவருடைய ஒவ்வொரு அசைவும் அவருடைய ஒவ்வொரு நடையும் ஹரே கிருஷ்ணா அப்படி ஒரு வளைந்து ஆடுறத ஆட்டம் மறக்கவே முடியாது.
His each move, his each walk, and when he sings Hare Krishna and dances, it cannot be ever forgotten.
இன்னைக்கும் நம்முடைய மனதில் பசுமரத்து ஆணி போல், அதாவது பசுமரத்தில் ஆணினா அந்த ஆணி ரொம்ப ஸ்ட்ராங்காக இருக்கிற மாதிரி அந்த நினைவுகள் இன்னைக்கு நமக்கு அதை சொல்ல சொல்ல ஆனந்தம்.
Just like a nail struck into a raw green tree is hard to plug out, similarly the memories of Harivilas Prabhu are deep ingrained in our minds, and they are, the more we think about them, the more we feel joyous.
அதை நினைக்க நினைக்க ஆனந்தம் தான். என்ன ஒரு அற்புதமான நாட்கள், மாயாபூரில் நாங்கள் Harivilas Prabhu தங்கியிருந்த நாட்கள், Harivilas மகாராஜியோட எங்கள் தச்சநல்லூரிலையும் அந்த காலேஜிலையும் அவரோடு பஸ்ஸில் ட்ரெயினிலையும் பஸ்ஸிலையும் பயணம் பண்ண நாட்கள் அப்பா சொல்ல முடியல.
The more I think about it, the more joyous I feel, especially the days I spent with Harivilas Prabhu in Mayapur, the college we visited for preaching, and when he came to our village, Tachanallur. And every time I think about it, I feel so joyous. When we traveled by bus, by train, it gives me inexplicable joy when I even think about this.
அந்த தீனதயாளன் அளவு கடந்த கருணையாளன் பகவான் கிருஷ்ணனுடைய சிறப்பே கருணை. அந்த கருணை தான் எங்களுக்கு Harivilas Prabhu மூலமாக கிடைச்சது.
இட் இஸ் த காஸ்ட்லெஸ் மெர்சி ஆஃப் த லார்ட் பகவான் ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா. ஹிஸ் பெனிஃபேக்டர் அண்ட் ஹிஸ் மெர்சி தட் வி ஆர் ஏபிள் டு அசோசியேட் வித் ஹிஸ் கிரேஸ் Harivilas Prabhu அண்ட் ஹிஸ் அன்லிமிட்டெட் மெர்சி.
Harivilas Prabhu மகாராஜி ஒரு வார்த்தை கூட அவர் இருந்த நாட்களில் ஒரு வார்த்தை கூட எங்ககிட்ட கடினமாக பேசவில்லைங்கிறதுக்காக எங்களுக்கு பிடிக்கும் சொல்ல அவர் கடினமாக பேசினாலும் எங்களுக்கு ஆனந்தம் தான்.
ஐ ஹவ் நெவர் சீன் Harivilas மகாராஜ் ஸ்பீக் எவர் ஸ்ட்ரிக்ட்லி ஆர் பிஹேவ் ஸ்ட்ரிக்ட்லி when he was with us. It doesn't mean that we like him because of that. Even if he is very strictly speaking, we still love him.
எங்களை அதாவது எப்படின்னா
பிரதீபகாஸ் மகாராஜ் வந்து எங்களுக்கு அப்பானா அரிவிலாஸ் பிரபு எங்களுக்கு சித்தப்பா அரிவிலாஸ் பிரபு மகாராஜிட்ட தான் நாங்கள் நெருங்கி பழக முடியும் அப்பா ரொம்ப பேசாரு அப்பா கிட்ட நம்ம போக முடியாது ஆனால் சித்தப்பா எங்களுக்கு ரொம்ப பிரியமாக இருப்பாங்க
We consider Harivilas Prabhu to be our father's brother or our uncle, and our father is His Holiness Bhaktivikas Swami Maharaj. It is always very scary to go to the father as he is very strict, but however, with an uncle, we are considered as very fond and affectionate devotees.
அந்த கிளாஸ் எடுக்கிற விதம் அரிவிலாஸ் பிரபு கூட உட்கார்ந்துருக்கும் போது எல்லாரும் சுற்றி இருந்து மகாராஜி கிளாஸ் கொடுத்துட்ருப்பாங்க நாங்கள் உட்காந்துருப்போம் இங்கே இருக்க எல்லாருக்கும் இங்கிலீஷ் தெரியும் எனக்கு இங்கிலீஷ் தெரியாது அவங்களாம் உயர்ந்த பக்தர்கள் நான் என்னுடைய ஆன்மீக சகோதரர்னு கூட சொல்லலாம் நண்பன் சொல்லலாம் சீனியர்னு சொல்லலாம் மதநாராயணன் பிரபு கூட அவருடைய கருணையெல்லாம் நாங்கள் அங்கே இருக்கும்போது ஒவ்வொரு இடத்துலையும் கிளாஸ் முடிஞ்சுன்னா அவர் கையை காட்டி அந்த ஸ்டைலாக சொல்லி அவனுக்கு சொல்லுன்னு சொல்லுவார் அந்த ஒரு விஷயமே போதும் எப்பா
ஹரிவிலாஸ் மகாராஜ் ஸ்டைல் ஆஃப் கிவிங் கிளாஸஸ் இஸ் வெரி ஃபினாமினல் எவ்ரிபடி இன் த கிளாஸ் நோஸ் இங்கிலீஷ் பட் ஐ ஆம் அன் இல்லிட்ரேட் காய் ஹூ டஸ் நாட் நோ இங்கிலீஷ் பட் மை காட் பிரதர் அண்ட் மை சீனியர் அண்ட் மை ஃப்ரெண்ட் His Grace Vedanayam Prabhu, if he is present in the class. After the class is over, Harivilas Prabhu always instructs Vedanayam Prabhu to translate the whole class to me in English. Just that one act makes me respect Harivilas Prabhu for his causeless mercy.
தாங்க முடியாது என்ன ஒரு ஆனந்தம் வாழ்க்கையில் ஆனந்தம் சொன்னால் நாங்கள்லாம் படிக்கிற காலத்தில் என்னெல்லாமோ விஷயங்களாக ஆனந்தம் சொன்னோம் ஆனால் ஆனந்தம் உண்மையான ஆனந்தம் ஹரிவிலாஸ் பிரபுவோடு நாங்கள் இருந்த நாட்கள் மட்டுமே ரொம்ப ஆனந்தமான நாட்கள் மறக்க முடியாது மறுபடி ஏக்கம் கொடுக்கக்கூடிய விஷயம் ஹரிவிலாஸ் மகாராஜோடு நாங்கள் இருந்த நாட்கள்
ஐ ஸ்டில் கேன் கெட் ஓவர் ஹவு ஹாப்பி ஐ ஃபீல் லிஸ்னிங் டு திஸ் கிளாஸ் அண்ட் His association when he lived with us. When we were studying, we thought other things give us happiness. But now I realize just his classes and this association makes me want more and more of Harivilas Prabhu Maharaj's classes and his causeless mercy.
அந்த மெட்ராஸாக இருக்கட்டும் மாயாபுராக இருக்கட்டும் திருநெல்வேலியாக இருக்கட்டும் திருச்செந்தூராக இருக்கட்டும் ஐயோ சொல்ல முடியவில்லை அது எப்படின்னா உங்களுக்கு நான் எப்படி விளக்கணும்னு தெரியல ரொம்ப அருமையான நாட்கள் அவருடைய ஒவ்வொரு அசைவையும் நாங்கள் ரசித்தோம்
The days in Mayapur, Madras, Thatchanur, Tirunelveli or Thiruchendur, every day I am unable to explain the joy and the happiness of being with Harivilas Prabhu.
அவர் நடக்கும்போது அவர் பேசும்போது ஐயோ பிரபுபாதா பிரபு ஆசி பக்திவேதானந்த சுவாமி பிரபுபாதா நாங்கள் பார்க்கல ஆனால் ஆசி பக்திவேதானந்த சுவாமி பிரபுபாதா உடைய கருணையில் அவருடைய நேரடியே அவரோடு இருந்த அந்த விஷயம் எங்களுக்கு பிரபுபாதாவோட ஏன்னா பிரபுபாதா அவ்வளோ கருணையாளன் பிரபுபாதான் பகவானை விட ஆச்சாரியன் கருணைன்னு சொல்லுவாங்க அந்த ஆச்சாரியனுடைய கருணை எங்களுக்கு அரிவிலாஸ் பிரபு மூலமாக கிடைத்தது
When he walks or when he talks, it almost felt like seeing A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada was a very, very merciful soul. And it is stated that the Acharya is more merciful than the Lord. And we saw that in front of our eyes in the form of Harivilas Prabhu Maharaj.
வாழ்க்கையில் மறக்க முடியாத நாட்கள் என்றென்றும் அதுக்கு ஹரிவிலாஸ் பிரபு இங்கே வந்து ஹரிவிலாஸ் மகாராஜி இங்கே வந்து என்னுடைய வேதநாராயண பிரபுடைய கருணையினால் கோபாலகிருஷ்ண தாஸ் சுமோகினி தேவி தாஸ்னு ரெண்டு சீடர்களை எடுத்திருக்காங்க
தீஸ் ஆர் வெரி வெரி அன்ஃபர்கெட்டபுள் டேஸ் ஹரிவிலாஸ் மகாராஜ் கிரேஷியஸ்லி கேம் டவுன் ஹியர் And he made two beautiful devotees, Gopal Krishna Das and Su Mohini Devi Dasis. for with the grace of His grace, Vedanarayan Prabhu.
அந்த சீடர்களும் நாங்களும் அவருக்கு சீடர்கள் தான், அவரும் எங்களுக்கு மாறாடி தான். நாங்களும் அவரோடு அவர் எங்களுக்கு கொடுத்த உற்சாகத்தோடு இன்னும் இன்னும் நாங்கள் பகவானை பற்றி பிரபுபாதா பற்றி சேவைகளில் இன்னும் உற்சாகமாக ஈடுபடுவதற்கு அருமையான விஷயங்களை எங்களுக்கு ஹரிவிலாஸ் பிரபு மகாராஜ் தந்திருக்காங்க.
Along with those disciples, we are also His disciples. He is our Maharaj. With the encouragement and the guidance He has provided us, we would want to do more and more for Bhagwan and propagate the message of Srila Prabhupada with His encouragement.
வாழ்க்கையில் மறக்கவே முடியாது. வாழ்க்கையில் என்றைக்கும் மறக்க முடியாத நாட்கள். இன்னும் நாங்கள் அவரோடு பழகணும், இன்னும் அவரோடு நாங்கள் பார்க்கணும், அவர் பக்கத்தில் இருக்கணும், அவரோடு பேசணுங்கிற ஆசை ரொம்ப அதிகமாக இருக்கு.
These are very, very unforgettable days in our lives. Very beautiful, very filled with lot of good memories, days. We want to spend more time with Him, associate with Him, be with Him. That is our desire.
என்னோட முதல் முதலாக வேதநாராயண பிரபு வந்து ஹரிவிலாஸ் பிரபு அப்படின்னு சொல்லும்போது அவர் ஹரிவிலாஸ் பிரபு பற்றி நிறைய சொல்லுவார். அப்போ எனக்கு ஹரிவிலாஸ் பிரபு பார்க்கணும் போல இருக்கும். அப்போ நான் யூடியூப்பில் ஹரிவிலாஸ் பிரபுன்னு போட்டு அடித்து பார்ப்பேன். சிங்கம் மாதிரி இருப்பார். அந்த சிங்கத்தை நாங்கள் நேரில் பார்த்தோம். அந்த சிங்கம் எங்களோடு உலாவிச்சு, அந்த சிங்கம் எங்களோடு இருந்துச்சுன்னு நினைக்கும் போது, அந்த ஆன்மீக சிங்கத்தை நினைக்கும் போது, பக்ஷிஸ்நாத மகாராஜ் நாங்கள் பார்த்ததில்லை, பிரபுபாதாவை பார்த்ததில்லை, ஆனால் ஹரிவிலாஸ் பிரபு சிங்கத்தை பார்த்துருக்கோம் அப்படிங்கிற ஆனந்தம் வாழ்க்கையில் மறக்கவே முடியாது. ஜெய்ஷில பிரபாதைக்கு.
When I first met Vedanayan Prabhu, he always used to keep telling me stories about how great Harivilas Prabhu Maharaj was, and I could not wait to see him. So I went on YouTube and I saw he looked like a lion, and he looked like a spiritual lion, and the lion talked to us, it walked amongst us, and it lived with us. And I have not seen Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, I have not seen Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj. However, to just to think that Harivilas Prabhu Maharaj walked amongst us is such a great, fortunate event for us. Jai Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.